and I am back. I am Sarim Khan, studying in 5th standard, and today we have mass energy equivalence. As we know, Einstein's famous equation equals to mc squared, which is also known as mass energy equivalence. Since energy and mass are equivalent, so today we are going to discuss over mass energy equivalence. What is it? What actually really is it? So what now? Okay, question arises, what is mass energy equivalence? So let me tell you that this equation E equals to mc squared. Okay, this equation is known as mass energy equivalence. Okay, generally, just like you can ask anyone, they will say about this equation equals to mc squared. But let me tell you the reality over mass energy equivalence, that actually Einstein in 1905, in his special theory of relativity paper, he patented another equation which was not this. Okay, the real equation was m equals to e by c squared. Okay, this was the real equation, m equals to e by c squared. But later when scientists tried to do cross multiplication, so we can write m as m by 1, so m by 1 equals to e by c squared, 1 will be multiplied with e and c squared will be multiplied with m. So finally what we got, so c squared times m is m times c squared. Okay, what we get equals to, now 1 times E is E. So what we get, mc squared equals to E. So we can write that equals to mc squared. This we have equals to mc squared. But let me tell you that actually what really those symbols stand. Okay, what really those symbols stand. So E stands for energy. E we can call as energy. Okay, is energy, this we can take, and m is mass, but not really simply mass, not total mass, it is loss of mass. M is loss of mass. Okay, loss of mass. Now c squared, what is c squared? So let me tell you, leave this square, the main c means speed of light. C means speed of light, whose value in vacuum is 3 into 10 raised to the power 8 meters per second. Okay, it is nearly equals to 3 into 10 raised to the power 8 meters per second. So, but even in generally an equation, we can take 3 into 10 raised to the power 8 meters per second. This we have. Now, what we can see, that E is energy, M is loss of mass, We can say that M is actually loss of mass and C is 3 into 10 raised to the power 8 meters per second. So, what we can say, that energy equals to loss of mass times the speed of light square. Because here C, this is value of C, but we need square of C. This is square, which is 9 into 10 raised to the power 16 meters per second. Okay, that is square of it. Now here what we can see, that why this was not main equation, this is not used so much, why the exact correct equation is m equals to e by c squared. Because what we can see, that Einstein actually really patented in 1905 year, what happened, that an unknown scientist to whom no one knew, actually he patented a special theory of relativity, one paper over it, and in that he dealt over mass energy equivalence and said that actually in our daily world, what can we can see, that if the loss of mass m, loss of mass is m and E is energy and C is speed of light, so when we find out relation between them, so what we get, that the relation between them is of m equals to e by c squared. Now here what we can see, he predicted that energy and mass are equivalent, means they are same quantities, means he predicted that mass is a form of energy. He predicted mass is also a form of energy, because when we go according to this equation, m equals to e by c squared, so we get that mass is also a form of energy, but generally equals to mc squared. When we go according to this equation, so we get it, that actually energy can be converted in mass and mass can be converted in energy, but this equation actually states that mass is itself a form of energy, means it itself is energy. So generally Einstein, you always forever used this equation, m equals to e by c squared, instead of using equals to mc squared. So the real main, which is correct equation. Now question arises, which is correct equation, equals to mc squared, or m equals to e by c squared. So first let me inform you that both are correct equations, both are correct equations, just like for using, for finding out the energy, we can find using equals to mc squared, and for finding out the loss of mass, we can find out using m equals to e by c squared. because those itself is state of another equation. But even then, let me tell you the correct statement, okay? Just like which theory of relativity or mass energy equivalence we have. M equals to E by C square follows its rule, while E equals to MC square doesn't. So actually, if we see according to mass energy equivalence, so this equation M equals to E by C square is correct, okay? So this first equation M equals to E by C square is a correct equation. Okay, now question arises that why do not we feel loss of mass in our day-to-day life? Why it is such that we do not feel loss of mass? Okay, so if we have to answer this question, so we need this equation M equals to E by C squared, because this predicts that if amount of energy is E, okay, if amount of energy in us is E and loss of mass is M, and okay, so why do not we feel this loss of mass in our day-to-day life? But generally many times we have a loss of mass in our day-to-day life. So actually main statement behind this by theory of relativity or mass energy equivalence is this, that actually C square is 3 into 10 raised to the power 8 meter per second, okay, its whole square, okay, whose value is what, 9 into 10 raised to the power 16 meter per second. This is C square value. Then if we have loss of mass as M, so M we can write M equals to E divided by 9 into 10 raised to the power 16, and this is the answer, because as high E value is present, but it cannot be so high as the value 9 into 10 raised to the power 16, because this is very high value. 9 into 10 raised to the power 16 is very high value. This is why answer we get in decimals of this, or E divided by 9 into 10 raised to the power 16, and this is why there is a very very less loss of mass. So we cannot feel this loss of mass in our day-to-day life. So this was my today's topic, and let me inform you that in my next video I'll try to prove the mass energy equivalence, this equals to mc squared or M equals to E by C squared. So if you haven't subscribed this channel, so please subscribe this channel. Thank you.